I begin my story out in West Virginia in a little college. All the student body only cared for football, never mind the knowledge. Never mind the sheepskin, they preferred the pigskin, seemed to have it in their bones. They knew all about it, couldn't live without it, all except a certain Mr. Jamboree Jones. He played the clarinet with all his might. He studied night and day, he practiced day and night. No running up the field for Mr. Jones. He'd rather run up the scales than down the scales. What tones, even though his buddies always got the studies to attend a rally. While they all were rooting, he'd be off tooting, what's become of Sally? How they used to hate him, coaches wouldn't date him, they thought he was an awful bore. Buddy liked his rhythm more than being with him, so he only grinned and went to practice some more. Meanwhile, the team marched on to greater fame, till they were asked to play the famous Rose Bowl game. And on that day of days, the students beamed. What did they do when the team marched on the field? They screamed, starting from the kickoff. They pulled every trick off, but they couldn't win it. Instead of going forward, they were going backward about a mile a minute. Seeing their position, they called intermission when they heard the referee say, 17-0 ain't exactly nothing when you only got about a minute to play. Then from the stands there came a distant wail, and it was Jamboree swinging Hold'em Yale. And then the students all began to yell. The players marched up the field and down the field, ba-boo-da-bid-da-doo-da, pell-mell. On a certain West Virginia hill, there stands that college still, just as it always will. And there's a picture in its hall of fame, and who's the boy in the frame who won that game? Jamboree Jones is the gentleman's name. Jamboree Jones is the gentleman's name. Jamboree, Jamboree Jones.